Greetings. Today is December the 5th, 2016. I'm standing in front of the Serenity Church as well as the Black Museum here in Valdosta, Georgia. Just like a Black Museum in Thomasville, where a Air Force retired Senior Chief Master Sergeant helped to create, started, and find, we also have one here in Valdosta, Georgia. Many locals have not even visited this facility. So I'm going inside and show you just a few minutes and talk to you a little bit about one of the most ignored museums, perhaps, in any city in the state of Georgia. And so now, before I go in, this morning, I was asked by a group of people to do some videos covering some sites, locations, and problems here in Valdosta, Georgia, as I have covered in so many other small towns and cities across the state of Georgia and in Florida. And that's what I'm going to do this morning. I'm going to Orly West, where there was a shooting. I'm going to talk a little bit about that at Valdosta Housing Authority. I'm going to leave there, and I'm going to other locations. And I believe that you have a right to know. Now let's go in to this museum here at Serenity Church under the leadership of Senior Servant Floyd E. Rose, as well as the Black contractors and Black business owners here in Valdosta who are fighting for equal justice under the law when it comes to the building of schools. They don't believe that $85 million to $135 million should leave Valdosta and Lowndes County and go to any other community, when it will be this same community that will pay through their taxes the money back for building this Valdosta High School. And many of these Black contractors are asking why the four Black Board of Education members have not broken ranks even once to say to the people that voted them in office, we want your children, your mothers, your fathers, and your uncles to get a fair share of these $85 to $135 million. So they are fighting on behalf of your children. Although you may not fight with them, they are yet fighting for your children. Your local news media outlets have already ignored Reverend Rose, Pastor Neal, Reverend Robinson, G.C. Kelly, and others as they address the Valdosta City School Board of Education. The beef of what took place in those meetings, beyond question, has been ignored by all of the local television stations, radio stations, and newspapers. Now, if you don't believe me, just Google Valdosta High School Black contractors seeking a fair share in the dollars that are being spent. Then check your newspaper, Google the TV stations, and see how much they reported about what took place at public meetings here in Valdosta, Georgia. Then call Victor Blackwell. Talk to him. Let him come and cover some of this information. And then ask me to come in with my videos to see if I can prove step by step the process how Black contractors have been ignored even by the news media network. The news media network. Now let's go in and let's see and let's hear about your history. You heard about their history. Now hear a little bit about your history.
I don't know how my people survived slavery. I do remember, that's why I believe. I don't know why the rivers overflow their banks. I don't know why the snow falls and covers the ground. I don't know why the hurricane sweeps through the land every now and then. Standing in storm, I believe. Hater, 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 hater,
hater, hater, hater, hater, hater, hater, hater, hater, hater, hater, hater, hater, hater, hater, hater, hater, hater,
hater, hater,
hater, hater, hater, it's amazing that many people here in Valdosta have never heard of this museum at 619 North Lee Street here in Valdosta, Georgia. I'm going to walk through the city. I just left from Reverend Rowe's office speaking with some concerned citizens, and I want to share with you what was discussed at this meeting this morning. Number one, this is Serenity Church, but it also is a museum founded by the Reverend Floyd E. Rose here in Valdosta, Georgia. And I'm inviting each and every one of you, all the schools with the children, to come down and tour the Serenity Museum. Black history. People that are a part of the landscape of America. Pictures with President Barack Obama, Leif Massantas, various people here in Valdosta and around the nation, Oprah Winfrey, Maya Angelou, you name it, and you'll find it here at Serenity Church. The Williams Sisters. This is a historic museum that any American will feel proud to tour. City councilmen, county commissioners, I'm sure that all of them, along with our school board of education members and members of the Chamber of Commerce, they have already been here and toured this museum. After all, it is a part of our history. When the various wars of this nation was in full swing, blacks and whites and Germans and Christians and Muslims and Jews and Hindu and you all participated together on the battlefield, in the foxholes, and in the graveyards. And so it's just natural that you should want to come and tour this museum. Greetings, this is the Get To Free Press, and I'm George Boston Rhines in Valdosta, Georgia. Standing in front of the Valdosta Housing Authority, Early West. This is a project, as they once called it, on the north side of town. And as you know, there was a shooting in this area of town last week. I was asked to come last week, but I'm just getting around to coming. I just talked to Mark Stalvey, and he talked to me about what's going on out here, and he gave me his pointers and ideas about how they possibly could help this environment. I am here today not to condemn the Valdosta Housing Authority or anyone else for that matter. I'm not here to condemn white people in terms of what they're not doing for black people. I'm here today because, like some of our elected officials, some have contacted me. They want me to talk about some subject matter like homeless people living in the woods here in the city of Valdosta, Georgia. They want me to talk about the unemployment here in Valdosta and Lowndes County among black Americans. They want me to discuss how we have blacks on city council, but some of them will not speak up concerning the problems in the black community. And I'm not here to criticize or condemn any of these people, nor the points that was made to me this morning at a meeting that I attended. But what I want to say to black people is that we cannot blame the white Ku Klux Klan, and we need to stop trying to pin everything on white America. For we have some problems in our community that must be addressed by black people. And one of those problems are that when a black person take the life of another black person, they should be equally held accountable as when we find white police officers gun down blacks during traffic stops for what some of us call no apparent reason. And so when blacks shoot other blacks, we should be equally outraged. Moreover, the family members, the parents, and relatives of a person that take the life of another innocent black person for no reason at all, or even if it's in self-defense, and if the law could have resolved the situation or another family member instead of taking another person's life, because that should bring discredit on that particular family. And I cannot understand how our sons and our daughters will take the life of another black man without the parents being held accountable, at least looked upon to understand that that's a bad family. That's a bad family if they took a life without any justification whatsoever. That whole family should have a mark or tarnish on their name. And how can family members respect a family member when they take the life of another human being and cast a white shadow on a black family in terms of taking human life, something that they can never replace? Much like the meeting I was in this morning when many of our local pastors are criticized about not being an active part in trying to resolve the problems in the community, I'm not here to condemn any pastor this morning. I am here because I care and because I was asked to address and to publish something about what's going on here in Valdosta, Lowndes County, in the state of Georgia. Many of our black kids does not have jobs at Belk's. Many black women and men are not waitresses at many of these local restaurants. And the rumor in the black community is that these white people in Valdosta will not hire blacks as waitresses because it's bad for business. Yet you and I spend our money at Mama June's, the Brown Pig, the Blue Pig, Miller Hardware, and other hardware stores right here in the city of Valdosta, Georgia. But we don't demand anything from these places where we buy our merchandise, such as Country Cobbler. If you buy Floor Shine shoes that cost anywhere from $89, $120 to $200 at Country Cobbler, when you walk in Country Cobbler shoe store, and if you don't see any black people employed, and if they have 5 to 10 or 15 or 20 or 100 employees, and they don't have any blacks employed, you may want to start asking yourself a question. Why should I spend my black green dollars in places where they will not hire me? And so this is something that we must do for ourselves. This is not to down, this is not to criticize, this is not to malign any other race or nationality of people. But we should have respect among ourselves as black people to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. That means if Koreans come into the black community and set up shop in the black community, take our black green dollars to take care of their families here in Valdosta or in some foreign nation of the world, we should not condemn them, but we should expect them to hire some of us, people of the black family, to show that they appreciate the black man, woman, and their children for spending money in their business. Now, if you don't demand that from people, then you should not blame them when they don't give you a damn thing to show for your patronage of those businesses. Now look, I didn't say that for you to go out and criticize the Indians who have taken upon themselves to set up shop in the black community and take your money and disrespect you and don't show you any appreciation or acknowledgement for the money that you spend in their community. I'm not here saying to you to condemn them. What I am saying to you is this. If they set up shop, including Caucasians, if they set up businesses in your community and take your money back home with them to take care of their children, send their children to private schools, and to make you look bad in the eyes of the public because they don't hire you. And so our children during the summer does not have a business to go work in. You can't blame them for that. What you need to do, we need to do, find a way to create businesses in their communities and get some of their money to help you take care of your children and to get a lawyer if they are pulled over by a police officer for nothing, so they can defend themselves against what some are calling an unjust justice law enforcement system or agency, as well as an unfair, unjust justice system. But if you, as a black American, continue to spend your money, not patronize others, not create businesses for yourself, and when you see blacks in business, you don't go to their store, you run to the Indians, the Koreans, the Japanese, the Chinese, but you stay on your knees in front of somebody else's business, but you would not patronize your own business. And when you fail to patronize your own business, you yourself are contributing to your children's delinquency, your children going into jails, prisons, and other institutions that are of little to no value to their children and coming generations of black children. Wait a minute. I haven't finished yet. Look, when you walk through Valdosta, Georgia, and you see all these roads being paved with asphalt, when you see all these new schools going up, when you see all of this, the landscaping in front of these businesses, and yet black folk are locked out of getting any of these federal dollars, should not that concern our black preachers who sit in the pulpit, holler hallelujah and hallelujah, but don't do anything that the majority of people can see other than collecting money and teaching them how to get to heaven? Wait a minute. Haven't finished yet. Now, even a fool want to go to heaven if what they said to us about heaven is correct. But before we get to heaven, we're going to need something. We're going to need to be loved. We need a house to live in. We need food to eat. We need an education to be able to compete. But if only the preacher, and if only the teacher, if only the deacon can get these things, while our children, black children, go to hell because we did not do for our children what the Indians are doing for their children, what the Japanese are doing for their children, what the Chinese are doing for their children. So why should we feel good about ourselves when we watch everybody else enjoy the fruits and the best of the land, and we keep going deeper and deeper in hell, and we cannot enjoy any of the finer things of this life until we get to heaven? Now, don't you think that is sickening? Black people can only wait and pray and preach and sing in the choir and hope that they can get into heaven before they start living, while everybody else are enjoying their life here and then going to heaven. But you are catching hell here. You may or may not go to heaven, and you may end up in hell like the hell you caught while you was here, because you did not do what God blessed others to do. I'm going to close this out now, but I want you to know that we as a people must do for ourselves and stop expecting others to do for us that which we are unwilling to do for ourselves. Now, I see people building churches, new churches going up all around town. Everybody want to set up their own movement. And when they set up these churches, and you can bear witness with this if you are not stuck too deep in the mud, many of these black churches need to consolidate, close some up down, because they ain't got but 3 members anyway, and unite together to do something good for the black race. Look, when we look around America, it's not the white Ku Klux Klan that's killing us. It's the black KKK among our own people that are destroying themselves. And it seems like we don't give a damn. But it is indeed time now for us to wake up, not only here in Valdosta, Lowndes County, in the state of Georgia, but across the United States. The black man, woman, and their children must begin to educate themselves. You have been indoctrinated. You have been incarcerated and pretty near annihilated, and you are still asleep. It is indeed time for the black man and woman to wake up from the spell of the Leviathan. Yes, look it up, the spell of the Leviathan. We as black folk must wake up. God demands, as Psalm 68:31 says, princes shall come out of Egypt, and Ethiopia shall soon stretch forth her hand unto God. Yesterday, we followed the white man teachings because we was robbed of our own history, robbed of our name, robbed of our God, robbed of our self-respect, labeled three-fifths of a human being, brought over on a ship called Jesus in the year 1555, captained by one European slave trader by the name of Sir John Hawkins. So we didn't know ourselves yesterday because of our own ignorance and forbidden to learn how to read, write, and learn arithmetic. But today, you don't have an excuse, black man, for wearing your pants down. Yesterday, the white man held you down. You couldn't pull your pants up because he wouldn't let you pull your pants up economically. But now, it's not the KKK that's making you wear your pants down. It's the black KKK that got you wearing your pants down. And nobody respects you, not even your own black people, with your pants down, because you are causing them to be shame of you in McDonald's, shame of you in the mall, shame of you in the public, shame, shame, shame. And it's time now, black man, to stand up and take charge of your life. Stop letting people beat your black woman down while you sit, say, and do nothing. God called us. We are ancestors. Built the pyramids in Egypt. And if we could build the pyramids, why can't we build up our own community and protect our black woman and our own black children? Somebody has sold you a mental pill that is no longer a thrill for you. Enemy that sells drugs to another human being. Calling the minister of America is a disgrace to his race.
God specializes.
Why would you sell death and destruction to your own people, your own mother, your own father, your own sister, your own brother? Why do you hate yourself so much, black man, that you're willing to destroy yourself? Don't look for the white man to protect you. Ain't nobody gonna save us, from us, for us, but us. And if we don't do it, then we are dead. As the ancient Hebrews that God's put in place to be the salt of the earth. You don't hear this in church because they don't want you free. God called me to give you the truth because I love you just that much. Lies will not free you, America. Only the truth can do that. And too many people have lied to you in the name of Jesus the Christ. Let me close now. Let me close with these words to the Christians. I don't give a damn for your Jesus. I don't give a damn for your Muhammad. I don't give a damn about your Moses, your Buddha. If you can see the hell that's going on in our community, and because of your love for Jesus, Muhammad, Buddha, and the rest, and you can't stand up to help save us, from us, for us, then why would I want to join Jesus? Why would I want to join Muhammad if your God can let you see what you see, and it don't make you outraged, if it don't make your heart bubble and trouble like my heart is trouble? I don't want to go to your heaven, even with your Jesus. I know another Jesus. I know another Buddha. I know another Muhammad. I know a Muhammad said, No greater love than this,
what, no,
that a man is willing to lay down his life for his neighbor. And so if you know Jesus, and if you are not willing to lay down your life for black folks shooting each other down like wild dogs, if you don't care enough about men putting dope in their veins and death in their brains and killing their little children, and you can't say nothing about it, you can't work to stop it
in your body.
No, I don't want to have nothing to do with your car. I want to go to the car
medicine
that love all me. Catholic, kill each other, and that God is concerned.
Are you friendless?
And he get on the street to talk to his people and post it on YouTube because he wants somebody.
Nobody
to be a reflection of his real love, and stop playing these silly ass games that people are playing, talking about I love Jesus. The hell you do! You don't love Jesus. You don't love God when you can just go to a church, clap your hand, placate, duplicate, and imitate Jesus and do nothing that that man stood for. You are a liar, and the truth is not in you. And I don't care how, excuse me for raising my voice, and I don't care how much you go to church. You can fool man, but you cannot fool the God of the black man's salvation. Now, y'all have a nice day. I want you to know I loved you just that much. I want to thank Reverend Martin for Citizens Against Violence. At least he want to be on record to say I'm trying to do something. And to the group I was with this morning that wanted me to say something about this, yeah, we're going to say something about it. I'm working 16 to 18 cities and counties across the state of Georgia with black elected officials that white people are trying to remove from office. And the news media will not tell their story. But me, the Ghetto Free Press, I report what others ignore because I am tired of seeing black people mistreated in North America after 461 years of our sojourn from Africa to the Western world. Now, y'all have a nice day. I'm George Boston Rhymes, standing in front of the Bell Austin Housing Authority, a federally funded housing complex. Federally funded. And we have fought to get money to come down through the contracts in redoing these facilities. We got black electricians that can do work to keep these apartments up. We got black landscapers that can be paid for fixing this up. We got black concrete, asphalt layers. We can do all of that. But the black man, like in the building of the new Bell Austin High School, they have blocked black man, black woman, and contractors from getting any of those dollars. Yet, when you see the black man rob convenience stores, break into your stores, you got names for them. But why don't you hire them? Why don't you hire them? I'll leave you with that question. And black man and woman, don't expect others to do for you that which you could, should do for yourself. Because remember, if you love the child that you produce, if you love your daughter, if you love your son or nephew or niece, just remember, ain't nobody gonna save us, from us, for us, but us. And if we don't save ourselves, ain't nobody gonna save us. Women, why do you date a man that can't pull his pants up? If he can't pull his pants up, how can he pull you and your children up? Wake up, black woman. Wake up. If he can't pull his pants up, he sure as hell or heaven can't pull you up. He can only take you down like his pants are down.
With the construction of the Sable Trail Pipeline, which jeopardizes the preservation of the Florida aquifer and puts our drinking water at risk. Our goal at Rethink Energy Florida is to engage, educate, and empower citizens to achieve energy independence and a more healthier, more sustainable environment. The Sable Trail Pipeline represents much of what our organization seeks to diminish. The prioritization of profits over humanity, consideration for the future, and an overall disregard for the environmental and social impacts. If this can happen here, it can happen in Florida, and it shouldn't happen anywhere. Thank you. Rethink Energy Florida is from Tallahassee, Florida.
Deborah Johnson. I'm from Spectrum Busters. I'm with Walls. I'm with Swamp Water Camp. We've been camping. We were cold, okay? Anyway, I know that the Whistler Coochie has been drilled, and we see the results of that. They are taking water out of the Santa Fe River now. Our group has been active in stopping, trying to stop, and has stopped some water trucks.
It's Gibson. I'm with the Sierra Club. I'm an organizer for that organization out of Florida. Sierra Club Golf Restoration Network, River Keepers organization such as Flint River Keeper, and also the Chattahoochee River Keeper, have all filed lawsuits against this particular pipeline project. Right now, there is a lawsuit in the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission or against the Federal Energy.
That'd be great. And you can make your own. You can pick one up. So I'm John Corp. I'm the president of Walls Watershed Coalition. We're the waterkeeper affiliate for the Upper Suwannee Basin, which includes the Withlacoochee River right down here. We'll be walking down to the river after we do the Georgia Water Coalition Dirty Dozen. We'll be walking down to the river to see where Sable Trail leaks drilling mud from their pilot hole. They were drilling under the river. They leaked drilling mud up into the river. Walls did a four-month legal case last year in Florida with a three-day hearing in Jasper, Florida. In that hearing, Sable Trail said, under oath, this could never happen. Well, it happened. So what else has happened that we don't know about? The only reason we know about this is because I and some other people from Walls were flying over in a South Wings flight, and we saw it. That's the only reason we know about this. What else is happening we don't know about? Even at this site, okay, we know it leaked up into the river. We don't know, did it leak sideways? Did it leak down into the aquifer? Will we find out when something comes up in somebody's well? Sable Trail doesn't know either. I asked them the other day down at the site, where else did it leak? All they could do was shake their heads, because they don't know. They don't know either. Nobody knows. That's why it's a bad idea to be putting this kind of pipeline and this kind of fragile karst geology in Florida, Georgia, or Alabama. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do today is at 10 o'clock, we're going to listen to the Georgia Water Coalition Dirty Dozen. Georgia Water Coalition is a group, I haven't heard of anything quite like this in any other state. It has 200 partner organizations throughout the state of Georgia. Every year they put out a list of a dozen worst threats to Georgia's waters. Now, I'm not supposed to tell you what's on that list until they tell you at 10 a.m. I can tell you that Sable Trail has been on this list 2 years running, in 2015 and in 2014 and 2015, because Walls asked for it to be on that list, and Flint Riverkeeper and others supported it. So this call about the Dirty Dozen, I'll be on this call. I'm going to have to get on the phone shortly to prepare for that. Gretchen Porterman here in the blue with the corporate personhood sign. She is the acting executive director of Walls. She will be assisting all of you, and Amy here with the Stop Corporate Greed side. She will also be helping you and everyone else and tell you lots of stuff. People will have another opportunity to talk
to you, the press, after we do the Dirty Dozen. And then after that, we walk down between these two bridges. By walk, I mean scramble down the rock slope, and then we will clamber up the sandy slope of the river 2,000 feet to where it leaked. It's not, you know, you're not going to see something like what happened in Alabama, fortunately. But you will see where the leak happened, and they said, under oath, in a legal case in Florida, could not happen. And we think that's significant. So thank you for coming. I'm going to prepare for the Dirty Dozen. Please feel free to go ahead and talk to people here, both before and afterwards. Dirty Dozen, they will speak again. And then we will scramble down the slope and look at the affected area. Thank you very much.